So today, I am very excited to have Dr. David Bates with me. Dr. Bates is the Chief of General Medicine at Brigham and Women's Hospital, where he's also the Chief Quality Officer. But the real reason we have him, beyond those very important positions he has, is that he has been the sort of pioneer in studying patient safety, health information technology, and how they intersect. Dave, thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for having me.
So I want to start off by first taking a theoretical example. Here we are at the Harvard School of Public Health. We're right across the street from Brigham and Women's Hospital. Imagine the Brigham is a typical American hospital. And I am a patient, I have some illness, and I go to the hospital, I go to the Brigham. What am I at risk at? From an adverse event, patient safety point of view, what are bad things that could happen to me if I'm at the hospital?
Well, of course, we try to do as much as we can to keep you from getting any of those bad things. But the fact is that there are a number of things that can happen. You could have an adverse drug event or be harmed by a medication.
So I'm going to just take a minute and write these down. So adverse drug event, keep going.
Yep, you could have a hospital-acquired infection.
Okay. So I'm going to call that HAI, hospital-acquired infection.
Yep, you could fall. You could develop a pressure ulcer.
Okay.
You could have a surgical complication.
Okay.
And you could have a deep venous thrombosis. Those are really the main causes of harm.
Okay, I'm going to call that DVT, deep venous thrombosis. So let's go through each of these a little bit more carefully. Adverse drug event, how do you think about it? What is an adverse drug event?
An adverse drug event is any injury that's caused by a medication.
Okay. And about how often do these occur in a typical, let's say, American or sort of Western hospital?
They happen in between 7 and 15 per 100 admissions.
Okay.
So infections, it's about 3 per 100 admissions.
Okay.
Fall is about 1%.
Okay.
Pressure ulcer is about 3%. Surgical complication is about 2%. You have to have surgery, obviously, to have a complication. And deep venous thrombosis is about 1%.
Okay. So none of these numbers offhand look very big. But is this a big problem?
It is a big problem. When you add them up, it turns out that somewhere between 10 and 25% of patients who come to the hospital have something bad happen to them as the result of the hospitalization. What the exact number is depends a little bit on how hard you look.
Is this a uniquely American problem, David?
No, we now have studies from all over the world that show that the rate of harm is on the order of this magnitude. In most of the international studies which have come from developed countries, the rate has been about 10 in 100 admissions.